Hello, hello, hello to my favorite fifth graders. Today I get to read you another book. It is called One Hen. These beautiful illustrations, and it says at the top how one small loan made a big difference. This is written by Katie Smith Milway, and it's illustrated by Eugenie Fernandez. It's a benchmark book. They provided it for us. It's also a Citizen Kid book, which is really cool. On the back, there's all these awesome books that I really just want to go and order now because they look awesome. Okay, so for this assignment, this is actually something that you can do for math for week 7. And after you listen to the book, then you get to brainstorm and come up with your own idea for how you could do something similar to what happens in this book. Now, obviously, you don't have to carry it out. It would just be a plan, a brainstorm of something that you could do similarly to what happens here. But it's a really cool story. I'll just kind of read you the intro. It says, this is the hen that Kojo bought. This is the story of how change happens in the world. One person, one family, one community at a time. Kojo lives in a small town in Ghana, West Africa. He and his mother survive by gathering and selling firewood. There is never much money or food, just enough to get by. When Kojo is given a small loan, he has an idea. He will use the money to buy a hen. If he buys a hen, they will have eggs to eat. Soon, there are extra eggs to sell at the market. With the profits, or the money that he has left over, the money that he makes, Kojo buys more hens and eventually earns enough for his school fees. After finishing school, he gets a bigger loan and gradually builds up a poultry farm, hires workers, and pays taxes that improve his community. Along the way, Kojo loans others money so that they too can leave poverty behind. One Hen is a persuasive story of how reaching out to help someone with a small loan can have a big impact. But it is more than just a story. Kojo is based on a real person, Kwebina Darko, who really did change his community, and now he's helping others do the same thing through a micro credit lending program. Change can happen one person at a time. So as we read the story, you can think about how if you were loaned some money, not a big amount of money, just some money, if someone loans it to you, that means eventually you have to pay it back. But Kojo was loaned some money, got a hen, and things built from there. He had enough money to pay the loan back, and he ended up changing so many lives, including his own. So let's get started. Whoa, the cover just came off. One Hen. Kojo tugs the knot tight and hoists a bundle of firewood onto his head. Since his father died, he has had to quit school and help his mother collect wood to sell at the market. It is the last load of the day, and he is tired and hungry. Kojo and his mother live in a mud-walled house with an open fire for cooking. Beside it is a garden where they grow their own food. They never have much money or much to eat. As Kojo nears the house, he can smell his mother's fufu cooking, their main meal made from cassava and yams. He begins to walk faster. Cassava is like yuca. It's a root. We eat it in South America. I cook it a lot, actually. It's pretty good stuff. It fills up your belly. So there's Kojo and there's his mama. Kojo's idea is to buy a hen. Sorry, I skipped the page. This is like a brand new book, so the pages are sticking together. Kojo and his mother live in a village in the Ashanti region of Ghana. None of the 20 families in the village have very much money, but they do have a good idea. Each family promises to save a bit of money so that one family can borrow all the savings to buy something important. The Achimpong family is first to borrow the money. They use it to buy 2 cartloads of fruit, which they sell for a profit at the market. When they pay back their loan, the Duodu family borrows the money to buy a secondhand sewing machine. They plan to turn the cloth they weave into shirts and dresses to sell. So profit, let's say you have $20 and you use that $20 to buy a sewing machine, okay, a very simple sewing machine. And you make a bunch of shirts and you sell the shirts and you end up making $50. Well, you started with $20. You got your $20 from the sale, but you didn't just make $20 and break even. You got $50. So your profit is the difference between how much you earned and how much you spent. So your profit, if you earned $50, you spent $20 to begin with, so your profit is $30. So that's what they mean when they're using that word. One day, it is Kojo's mother's turn. She uses the loan to buy a cart so she can carry more firewood to market. She also hopes to rent the cart to people who need transport. That's a good idea. There are a few coins left over, though. So Kojo asks if he can have them to buy something for himself. He has a good idea too. So this is the loan that Kojo gets. It's just a few coins. And this is what his mom, she spends it on getting this cart so that she can have more firewood and she could actually rent the cart out and make money that way. So as I gave away earlier, Kojo's idea is to buy a hen. He and his mother will eat some of the eggs it lays and sell the rest at the market. There is a farmer in the neighboring village with many hens, and Kojo will ask to buy one. It takes Kojo 2 hours to walk to the chicken farm. By the time he arrives, he's hot and dusty. He wonders how he will know which hen to choose. There's so many. Kojo tries to look over all the chickens. A white one pecks to the ground near his foot. Should he choose this hen? A speckled one flaps her wings and clucks. Perhaps she is the one. All at once, Kojo spies a plump brown hen with a bright red comb sitting in her nest and puffing out her feathers. She looks as if she would enjoy laying eggs. Now he doesn't have to think. He knows in his heart that she is the one. Kojo pays for the brown hen and puts her in a wicker basket. He gently covers the hen with a cloth and lifts the basket onto his head. As he walks home, he dreams about the future and he sees a lot of eggs in it. Eggs to eat, and if he's lucky, eggs that he can sell to buy more hens. That night, he put the basket with the hen beside his bed mat to keep it safe. Kojo makes a nest for his hen from the old wash powder box and checks it for eggs every day. On the first day, he finds nothing. On the second day, still no. But what is this? In the corner, under some straw, a smooth brown egg. Kojo is lucky indeed. His hen does seem to enjoy laying eggs. She lays 5 eggs the first week. Kojo and his mother eat 1 egg apiece, and he saves the other 3 for the market on Saturday. On market day, he walks among the stalls of fruit, vegetables, meats, kente cloths, and calabash bowls. He finds a good place to set down a small basket and calls out to the customers. Kojo sells 2 eggs to Ma Achimpong and 1 to Ma Duodo. He clutches his egg money tightly so he won't lose it. He is about to pack up his basket and go home when he finds another treasure. loose grains and bits of fruit fallen on the ground that can feed his hen. Slowly, slowly, Kojo's egg money grows. After 2 months, he saves enough to pay his mother back. In 4 months, he has enough to buy another hen. Now, Kojo can sell 5 eggs a week, and he has his mother. He and his mother have more to eat. After 6 months, he buys a third hen, and he and his mother have an egg a day. Kojo is proud of his eggs, and his mother is proud of Kojo. Bit by bit, one small hen is making a difference. So he was able, so at first he sold these eggs, but he wasn't making any money yet because he had to pay his mom back the loan. When you get a loan, you always end up having to pay it back. But then he was able to pay it back. Then he was able to earn profit. Then he was able to get another hen and earn even more profit because he was selling more eggs. So this kid is pretty financially smart. He's got a good noggin. He's got a good brain. He's thinking very smartly about how he can wisely use his money to earn profit. He's also thinking wisely about how to feed his hen, because if you think about it, that's another expense. That's another thing that he's got to think about. Does he need to buy food for his hen? Well, he found a free way to do it at the market. There's loose fruit pieces and grains on the ground. So if he collects those to feed his hen, that's not an expense for him. So that's not money coming out of his pocket. And then he gets more profit. So here is Kojo at the market selling his eggs. And this is what it looks like in the little basket when she lays her eggs in the straw. One year later, Kojo has built up his flock to 25 hens. He thinks the sound of chickens clucking and skittering about their enclosure is better than the beating of festival drums. But collecting eggs from so many hens is hard work. His speckled hen tries to hide her eggs. Today he finds one under a cassava plant, and his white hen pecks at him when he checks their nests. Then there is the brown hen with the big red comb, his first and still his favorite. She always seems to have a smooth brown egg for him. Selling eggs at the market has given Kojo some savings. Maybe he will use his egg money to build a fine wooden chicken coop. Maybe he will buy some things for his mother needs, such as a new water bucket and a good knife. Or maybe he can pay for something he's been dreaming of, fees and a uniform so that he can go back to school. "Your eggs have made us stronger, Kojo," said his mother. "Now, go to school and learn for the both of us." These are the chickens Kojo buys with the money he got from selling the eggs. Think of all the work that he went to just so that he would be able to go to school and earn his education. Would you go through all that work to save money and sell eggs and take care of chickens so that you could go to school? Kojo's uniform feels stiff and new as he walks to school. With each step, his lips move silently, reciting the ABCs and the numbers he learned before his father died. In school, Kojo works hard to catch up with the other students on reading and spelling and arithmetic. Later, he learns to write essays and solve math and science problems. And he learns about his country's history and its resources and all about the other countries in Africa and around the world. There are practical lessons for the country life too, like how to filter drinking water with a cloth to remove parasites, how to use chicken manure and compost made from garbage to fertilize soil and grow vegetables. The lessons Kojo learns help him care better for his chickens. His dreams are growing bigger, but now he sees that he will need more education to make them come true. Kojo studies even harder and wins a scholarship to an agricultural college to learn more about farming. His mother will care for his chickens while he is away. At college, Kojo's dreams start to take shape, the shape of a farm of his own. So this is the school Kojo attends with the fees he paid from the money he made selling his eggs. So really cool. He had this dream, and then the education that he got helped to make his dreams come true. Pretty cool. I love his love for learning. So inspiring. After Kojo finishes college, he decides to take a big risk. He will use all the money he and his mother have saved to start a real poultry farm. He buys a large plot of land and enough wood and wire to build chicken coops. Now he needs hens, 900 of them, to start the farm. He needs another loan this time, and a big one. This time, Kojo goes to the bank in Kumasi, a nearby town. When the banker hears that Kojo wants to buy 900 hens, he shakes his head. He does not want to lend money to a young man from a poor family. But Kojo does not give up. He goes to the capital city, Accra, and visits the bank's headquarters. Kojo waits and waits to see the bank president. The bank is near closing when finally the president agrees to see him. But not for long. He's a busy man. Kojo tells the banker that he has schooling and will work hard. The banker has heard such stories before and frowns. Kojo tells him about the small loan and the brown hen and the egg money that he used to build his flock. The banker sits back in his chair and taps his fingers together. This is not a story he hears every day. He smiles and nods. Kojo will get his loan. The banker and Kojo shake hands. Back home, Kojo buys his hens. Soon there will be eggs, so many eggs, that he will need helpers to collect them all. This is the farm that Kojo builds using the lessons he learned at college and a loan from the bank. So here is the farm. You can see them in the background shaking hands and the chicken coop. Kojo's hens are good layers. There are more than enough eggs for his whole village, so he travels to Kumasi to sell to the shopkeepers there. One shopkeeper is called Kwasi. Kojo knows him well. This man grew up in the same village that Kojo's father did and was a good friend. Kojo always goes to Kwasi's shop last and sometimes stays for supper. He likes to hear stories about his father, and he likes the peanut stew and palm oil soup that Kwasi's daughter makes. Her name is Ama, and she is a teacher. She has many stories about boys just like Kojo once was, boys who want to learn and who have big dreams. Kojo loves these stories, and he visits more and more often. He wishes he could hear Ama's stories every day, so one day he asks if she will be his wife. Ama is proud to marry Kojo and join him on the farm. Soon, Kojo and Ama are able to be parents. As the years go by, they have 3 boys and 2 girls, all strong and clever. With the money from Kojo's eggs, they build a bigger house of cinder blocks and stucco. Kojo's mother comes to live with them and tend to the garden. She will never have to sell firewood again. I didn't show you the picture. This is the family Kojo raises on the farm that he built with the money that he made. So there's his wife and his mom and his kiddos. Pretty amazing. And awesome that this is a true story based on the life of a real guy. Before long, many people are working on Kojo's farm. Men come to feed the chickens and clean the coops. Women collect the eggs and pack them in boxes. Still, other workers drive the eggs to markets in Kumasi and Accra. The workers have families. In all, 120 people depend on the wages from Kojo's farm. Families like the Adonkers have enough food to eat and money for their children's school fees. Ma Adonker can buy medicine with her daughter Adika when she falls ill. Pa Adonker can rebuild the walls of their mud home with cinder blocks and buy wood-stamped Adinkra clothes for special occasions. The workers on Kojo's farm can even afford livestock of their own. Some families buy a goat, others a sheep, and some start with one brown hen. These are the people Kojo hires to work on the farm that he built with the money that he made from the eggs from his, that began with his one small hen. Kojo's farm is now the largest in Ghana, the largest in his country. And his town has grown too. Some people come to find jobs on the farm and build homes for their families. Others come to the town to open shops and sell wares to the workers. One day, as Kojo tallies the accounts, he hears a knock on the door. Adika Adonker, all grown up now, is there. She greets Kojo and then holds out a small sack of coins. She tells Kojo that she has saved her wages. With just a bit more, she says, she could buy a mechanical grain mill and start a small business helping farmers turn their grain into flour. Would it be possible for her to have a small loan? Kojo knows Adika's family well. They have worked on the farm for many years, and he likes her idea. But he makes Adika promise that one day she will loan money to another family. Adika agrees, and bit by bit, one person helps another. The lives of many families in the town improve, and so do the lives of their children. More children have enough to eat, more children go to school, and more children are healthy. This is the town that grows as Kojo sells his eggs and pays his workers. So cool. As the years pass, Kojo's poultry farm becomes the largest in all of West Africa. Ah, so cool. He is older now and he's a proud grandfather. His grandchildren visit often and help collect eggs. Where will this one go, they ask, and that one? To Bamako in Mali or to Awandua in Burkina Faso? Kojo's workers pack thousands of eggs a day, and Kojo feels proud each time an egg truck pulls away to take food to families in neighboring countries. So now his eggs are going, they're being taken to other countries. Awesome. By now, Kojo has paid many taxes to the government of Ghana. So have his workers and the shopkeepers who sell his eggs. The government uses the tax money to build roads, schools, and health clinics across the country. It uses the money to improve the port at Accra, where ships from many countries come to trade. One more egg truck drives away, and Kojo looks down at his youngest grandson. The next time the boy asks Kojo where an egg will go, Kojo will say, "To your future, my child." This is the country that grows as businesses like Kojo's and Adika's prosper. This is the way that one young boy named Kojo, with one small loan to buy one brown hen, eventually changed the lives of his family, his community, his town, and his country. It all started with a good idea and a small loan that made it come true. It all started with one hen.
Okay, so this is the real
Kojo. That's the real guy.
Very cool. So, what I would like for you to do is think about what dream do you have? What is one small step that you could make to making a difference in your community? The little girl that Kojo made the loan to, she wanted a mill so that she could make the grain that they had in the community into flour so that they could bake bread and make things out of flour. I know when I was in Ecuador, in the jungle, one of my kids, she said, I really wish that there was a way for me to get the Wi-Fi to be able to reach everybody so that they could use online resources just like we do. So because we had internet at the little school that we were using. So just brainstorm, I think, for your activity. Just brainstorm something that maybe you could do one small step and maybe what that would lead to and what that would lead to. And think about, as we're learning about these concepts in math, like profit and income and taxes and all of these great financial words, this is definitely a part of math that you are going to use for the rest of your life, and the importance of knowing how much to spend and balancing your budget so that you can earn profit. So I'm excited to see your ideas. I hope that you liked this book. I'm excited to order more books from this Citizen Kid collection. So good luck, be creative. Let your mind dream away, and we'll see you next time. Bye.